Once upon a time, in a small town full of curious children, lived a knowledgeable and friendly lady named Mrs. Howto. She loved sharing her wisdom with the children and was excited about her new lesson on the wonders of weather. "Gather around, dear children," Mrs. Howto called out. "Today we will learn about the marvelous world of weather." The children gathered around, eager to start the adventure. "Firstly, let's talk about clouds," Mrs. Howto began. "Clouds are made of tiny water droplets, and they form when warm air rises, cools, and condenses." The children listened attentively. Suddenly, Mr. Cumulus, a fluffy white cloud character, floated in. "Hello, kids, I'm a cumulus cloud," he said. "I usually indicate good weather." Mrs. Howto continued, "Now let's learn about thunder and lightning. Lightning occurs due to the separation of positive and negative charges within a cloud." As she spoke, Mr. Bolt, a crackling lightning character, appeared. "I'm Mr. Bolt," he said. "I light up the sky during a storm. Remember, kids, safety first during a thunderstorm." "Thunder," Mrs. Howto explained, "is the sound that lightning makes due to the rapid heating and cooling of the air." The children were fascinated. "And then comes the rain," Mrs. Howto said. "Rain is formed when the tiny water droplets in clouds become too heavy and fall to the ground." Suddenly, Mrs. Raindrop, a sparkling raindrop character, splashed in. "I'm Mrs. Raindrop," she said. "I bring life to plants and fill up your rivers and lakes." Mrs. Howto turned to the children. "So why is weather important?" "Well, it affects the growth of plants, the behavior of animals, and our daily life." Suddenly, Mr. Tree, a tall green tree character, waved his branches. "I'm Mr. Tree," he announced. "Rain helps me grow and gives me life." Mrs. Howto added, "Plants like Mr. Tree need rain to grow, and animals need plants for food and shelter. So, you see, everything is interconnected." "That's right," chirped Mrs. Bird, a vibrant bird character fluttering in. "I build my nest in trees like Mr. Tree and feed on seeds and fruits." "And that's how weather plays a crucial role in the cycle of life," Mrs. Howto concluded. The children clapped and they thanked their weather friends for the lesson. "Remember, children," Mrs. Howto said, "respect nature and it will take care of you. Now, who wants to draw pictures of our weather friends?" The children cheered, ready for the fun activity. The children spent the rest of the day drawing and coloring their weather friends. They were excited to share their art with their families and tell them all about what they learned. As the sun began to set, the children thanked Mrs. Howto for the fun and informative day. They promised to share the knowledge they gained with their friends. Mrs. Howto waved goodbye to the children, her heart filled with joy. She was glad to have shared the wonders of weather with them and looked forward to their next learning adventure. "Remember, keep exploring, keep learning," Mrs. Howto called out to them as they left. The children waved back, their minds buzzing with newfound knowledge and curiosity about the world around them. That evening, the town buzzed with stories of Mrs. Howto and her weather friends. Parents were pleased, and the children couldn't wait for their next lesson. The day had been a success. Word of Mrs. Howto's lessons spread, and soon children from neighboring towns joined in. They were eager to learn from Mrs. Howto and her fascinating friends. The children's artwork was displayed in the town square, showcasing the lively characters of Mr. Cumulus, Mr. Bolt, Mrs. Raindrop, Mr. Tree, and Mrs. Bird. The display was a hit. "The best way to learn is through fun and interaction," Mrs. Howto would often say. True to her words, her lessons were always filled with joy, engagement, and a spirit of discovery. As days turned into weeks, Mrs. Howto's lessons became the highlight of the children's lives. They learned, laughed, and discovered the wonders of the world around them. Mrs. Howto's stories became a sensation, even catching the eye of the local news. Everyone was talking about the friendly lady who was educating children in such a unique and engaging way. And so Mrs. Howto continued her mission of spreading knowledge and curiosity. Her stories, filled with vibrant characters and valuable lessons, were a source of joy and inspiration for all. Soon, Mrs. Howto's stories found their way onto YouTube, reaching a global audience. Children from around the world now had the opportunity to learn about the wonders of weather. With each new video, Mrs. Howto's subscriber count grew, and so did the children's knowledge. The comments section was filled with words of appreciation and requests for more topics. Mrs. Howto's stories not only taught children about the world around them, but also instilled in them a love for learning. Each lesson was a new adventure, a journey of discovery and fun. And so, the journey continues. With Mrs. Howto at the helm, the children are set to explore more wonders of the world. Every new day is an opportunity to learn and grow. As we leave Mrs. Howto and her little learners for now, one thing is clear. Learning is a never-ending journey, and with the right guide, it can be the most exciting adventure of all. So, dear reader, if you're ever in Mrs. Howto's town, don't miss her lessons. For in her company, you'll learn, laugh, and discover the marvelous wonders of our world. And remember, as Mrs. Howto always says, keep exploring, keep learning. Who knows what wonderful discoveries await you in the fascinating world around us. Until next time, keep your eyes open and your minds curious. The world is full of wonders waiting to be discovered, and each new day brings new lessons to learn. So here's to Mrs. Howto, her weather friends, and their incredible lessons. May their stories continue to inspire, educate, and bring joy to children everywhere.